Hey guys, how's it going? So today, I want to start off by telling you all a story. So all the way back in 8th grade, I built up enough courage to ask a girl for her number, and surprisingly, I got it. But later that day, I got home, I was in a great mood, I decided to call her, and she didn't pick up. Instead, I heard this.
Hello, this is not the person you were trying to call. You've reached the rejection hotline.
No, I'm just kidding, that didn't really happen. I wish it did though, that would be a great intro for this video. Even though if that did happen, little Gabe probably would have been pretty sad by that. There's actually also a rejection text line that if you text her something like, hey, it automatically replies with this message. Oh, hello there. If you're reading this message, you've made a woman feel unsafe or disrespected. Please learn to take no for an answer and respect women's emotional and physical autonomy. Okay, thanks. Whoa, that was more powerful than I thought. Anyway. So you've probably heard of the rejection hotline before, but there's a lot of hotlines kind of similar to that that you've probably never heard of. So right now we're gonna call some of these hotlines that I've never heard of. I also found some scary phone numbers that people say you shouldn't call because the phone number is cursed. Which, if you know me, I don't really believe in this kind of stuff. Like, a phone number can't be cursed. What the hell? Let's start. The bad breath hotline. If this one happened to me, a girl gave me this number, this would cut deeper than the rejection one. Just imagine this, you got a girl's number, you think you polled, and then you hear this.
Hello, the person who gave you this phone number to call wants you to know that you have bad breath. Seriously, your breath smells very bad. This message is not intended to be mean, quite the opposite. This bad breath notification message is intended to help you improve your life and the lives of those you breathe near. That breath is disgustingly nasty. You have bad breath. That makes you disgustingly nasty. So please do something about your bad breath. Have a nice day.
Damn, this hotline is obviously a joke, but it can actually do some good in the world. How does Kitty's breath smell? Kind of smells like a reasonably priced seafood restaurant. Next one we're gonna call, this one you know might be the most useful out of all. Because if you have a friend that just won't stop complaining, don't worry because there's a stop complaining hotline. I think I listened to like 5 seconds of it. I think it shames you.
Every 35 seconds, an American child is reported abused or neglected. Every 20 seconds, an American suffers a heart attack. Every 18 seconds, an American woman is beaten. Every 14 seconds, the person who gave you this number wants you to keep all that in mind while you're stressing out or complaining about whatever petty problems or insignificant issues you've been obsessing over lately. Because during your time spent listening to my voice, there will be 2 abused or neglected children, 3 heart attack victims, 3 beaten women, 4 traffic crashes with injuries, 6 burglaries, and 10 violent crimes will be committed. So please, shut the fuck up. Stop being such a whiny little bitch.
Wow, that was more real than I thought it was gonna be. I think if you gave that to someone, pretty effective though. If you sent someone this, it's true. I guess they can't complain about like, oh, my phone is slow, when you just heard something like, children are dying. This could even be good for people that are just stressed, just to kind of like, it's okay, at least you're not dying in a car accident. Does that help? Next one, I don't even know what to expect from this one. It might not even be good enough for the video. It's called How to Entertain an Idiot Hotline. I'm guessing from the title, it's gonna try to make me seem look stupid somehow, and it's not gonna work, because I'm not idiot.
Hello, and thanks for calling How to Keep an Idiot Entertained, where we will show you how to keep an idiot entertained. We're talking totally and completely entertained. So much so that he or she won't be doing anything else, just sitting there, listening, completely captivated, their stupid little brains pleasantly preoccupied with something that nobody with an IQ over 20 would find remotely entertaining. That's right, they'll be staring off into space, their eyes glazed over like cavemen. And now, let's begin. Wait, no need, because we're already done. If you're still listening, then we have just successfully kept an idiot entertained for an entire minute.
That's it? I don't even get a say? It's just, I listen to it and I'm stupid? I thought it was gonna pull some like clever trick to make me like keep doing the same thing or all. I just listen to it and I'm an idiot? That went by so fast too. I don't even know what he said in the call. I'm just deeply offended. That's all I know. Next, you know, let's try some scary ones next. So I found this list of phone numbers online that people say when you call it, it's supposed to be creepy or the number is supposedly like haunted. So let's pick one of these numbers to call. Start the scary music to make me calling these numbers scarier than it probably actually is. There's a couple to choose from. Let's start by calling this number, 666. It says, in the USA, there is an urban legend about the phone number 666. They say if you call it, you will contact the devil. Wow. It's that easy, huh? It's only three numbers. It's like having Satan on speed dial. Okay, well, we're gonna get to the bottom of this and find out what really happens when you call the number 666. Let's call my boy Satan. It's ringing.
The number or code you have dialed is incorrect. Please check the number or...
Let's try a different one. Let's do this number. 99999. According to an urban legend in Thailand, 999 is a cursed number. If you call it and make a wish, your wish will be granted. However, you will soon die afterwards in a freak accident. Ooh, I get a wish. I mean, who cares about the second part if I get a wish? 999999.
Thank you for calling Zane's Law, and thank you for trusting our Zane's Law lawyers to help you on your case. If you are calling to open a new case, press 1. Otherwise, press 2.
Okay, well, that one was not what I expected. I don't need a lawyer. These scary ones are lame. Let's try one more scary one. This one is pretty well known. If you look it up, you'll find stuff on it. So apparently it's this number that you're seeing on the screen right now, and it's to a company called Booth World. I read like one article on this phone number, so I'm not an expert, but what people say is that this company remodels your life, and no one knows what that means. You can look it up. There's stories of people saying they call this number and then the person on the other line told them that the number is traced. Some people have said that they've gotten text messages a couple hours later saying that the remodel has begun. Even for me, this one sounds pretty creepy. It's a good story, but it's probably bullshit, so let's call it.
You have reached Booth World Industries. Your number has been logged and traced. A service representative will be with you shortly for remodeling. We at Booth World Industries say thanks. You have a marvelous day.
From what I read online, I should be scared, but it's a phone number. Nothing's gonna happen. Like that, I think that's just a prank phone number. And what kind of name is Booth World? Like, it sounds like Disney World, but lame. Okay, anyway, these scary numbers kind of lame. Let's just go back to the hotlines. Let's call this one. It's pretty similar to the rejection hotline that I mentioned earlier, but it's worse. A lot worse. Because we're gonna call the divorce hotline. I guess this is like the rejection hotline, but if you accidentally married that person and had like three beautiful children instead.
Are you tired of constant nagging, infrequent sex, or always being wrong? Do you find yourself apologizing for things you haven't done? Have you ever questioned where everything in your life went so wrong? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you may be one of the millions of Americans suffering from a chronic condition known as marriage. But don't worry, because there is a cure. Ask your lawyer if divorce might be right for you. Divorce is the low-cost alternative to homicide and has been clinically proven to improve mood, self-esteem, and libido.
Homicide? Wow, I guess that's more of like a diagnosis kind of divorce. I guess I'll save this number whenever I need a divorce. Let's do a couple more Santa hotline. It's not Christmas, but whatever.
You have reached a number that has been disconnected.
Santa? Oh, I put the wrong number. I switched to.
Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas. It's me, Santa Claus. And I'm here in the North Pole with my elves and my reindeer and that ho, 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 Mrs. Claus. We're hard at work making toys for Christmas. But if you would like a wooden doll, say the word doll. If you would like a sweater, say the word sweater. Santa can't help but notice that you didn't make a selection. Are you too good for a doll or a sweater? Well, what the f*** do you want for Christmas then, huh? I bet you'd like an iPod or a Nintendo Wii or an Xbox, wouldn't you, you greedy little f***? Do you know how hard it is to make something like that? I've already electrocuted four elves trying to replicate that damn iPhone. These are not skilled technicians. They're basically semi-retarded midgets in green tights with a helium addition. Have you forgotten the true meaning of Christmas? Well, guess what? Now you get nothing. You can all kiss Santa's frostbitten rosy red ass and go to hell.
Whoa. I feel bad. I wanted the sweater. I was gonna say yeah. In the beginning though, I'm gonna have to rewatch it. Did he call Mrs. Claus a hoe, or was he just saying ho 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 and it sounded like that?
Send my reindeer and that ho 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 Mrs. Claus.
Oh, okay, he did. Yep, she a hoe. Okay, last one. We're gonna call the sobriety test hotline. I don't really get this one from the name. Are you supposed to like make your intoxicated friend call this?
Thank you for calling the automated sobriety test. The automated sobriety test uses a variety of scientific questions and careful mathematical analysis to deduce whether a caller is sober, buzzed, or completely shit-cocked. Let's begin. Have you had much liquor that drinking beer is actually sobering you up? Has a drunk homeless man offered to call you a cab? Have you accused an Asian person of giving you evil eyes? Did you soil your pants and accuse someone else of pooping in them? Does stealing a gun from a cop just to see if you can seem like a good idea right now? Have you accidentally drunk dialed a relative? Did you then get angry when that relative didn't want to meet up with you?
Jesus, okay, this is a lot. I can't stand. That one was interesting, kind of racist, but hey, you know. Okay, well, that was the last hotline I'm gonna call, which means this video is done. I hope all of you use these numbers and give it to people that you want to fuck off, or even just call them when you're bored and you wanna pretend you have someone to talk to. Either one is cool. If you enjoyed this video, hit it with a thumbs up. But yeah, that's all for this video. Thank you guys for making it to the end of the video. I love you guys, and hopefully, I'll see you next week. I'm gonna go write some essays, because it's due in a couple days, 10 pages. Kill me.